Congregation, the First Baptist Church is very proud and pleased to be a part of a dynamic community like the city of Conroe. We love this city very, very much, and so we've been thinking about what kind of gift could we give to our community that would be meaningful. And so our choir and our music ministry and our congregation decided that perhaps the grandest thing we could do is give to the community a gift of Christmas celebration. This is our second annual Conroe Christmas Celebration. We hope that tonight evokes lots of emotions and lots of response from you. We want you to laugh and we want you to cry. We want you to applaud and be very meditative and quiet. We hope that you feel very, very close to God during this evening and that you have a new revelation of what Jesus Christ is all about in the spirit of Christmas. We want you to relax now. The orchestra, the drama, the choir is under the direction of Mr. David Harrell, who is our minister of music at First Baptist Church. If you enjoy this evening, and if you feel the wonderful spirit of Christmas when you leave here tonight, then all of the effort and all of the work that has gone into this evening will be very worthwhile. Now, may God bless you, and we hope that you enjoy this evening very, very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Somebody snitched on me. I put a snake in sister's bed. Somebody snitched on me. I put some ink on mommy's rug. I made Tommy eat a bug. Bought some gum with a penny slug. Somebody snitched on me. I'm getting nothing for Christmas. Mommy and Daddy are mad. I'm getting nothing for Christmas, 'cause I ain't been nothing but bad. You put a tack in teacher's chair. Somebody snitched on me. You tied a knot in Susie's hair. Somebody snitched on me. I did a dance on mommy's plants. Climbed a tree and tore my pants. Filled the sugar bowl with ants. Somebody snitched on me. You're getting nothing for Christmas.
I don't want nothing anyway.
Mommy and Daddy are mad.
Boy, are they mad.
You're getting nothing for Christmas.
Guess I could use a new bike.
'Cause you ain't been nothing but bad. I won't be seeing Santa Claus. Somebody snitched on you. He won't come visit me because somebody snitched on you. Next year I'll be old, that's right. Next year I'll be good, just wait. I'd start now, but it's too late. Somebody snitched on me. I'm getting nothing for Christmas.
through the snow in one horse open sleigh. O'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bars are ringing, making spirits bright. What fun it is to laugh and sing a sleigh song tonight. Jingle bells, we're gonna jingle all the way. Hey, hey, hey. What fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh. Hey, hey, hey. Jingle, jingle bells are ringing all the way.
Let it snow, let it snow.
It doesn't
didn't show signs of stopping, so I bought a little corn for popping.
Now the lights are way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
When we finally say goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, well, all the way home I'll be warm. Now the fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh, and every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so we're offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle, jingle, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
And when true love and grace. Thank you. Lead my people across the Jordan River into the promised land. I say to you what I said to Moses, every place upon which your foot shall tread, that will be the land of Israel. All the way from the Niger Desert in the south to the Lebanon Mountains in the north, and from the Mediterranean Sea in the west to the Euphrates River in the east. No one will be able to oppose you as long as you live, for I will be with you just as I was with Moses. I will not abandon you nor fail to help you. Be strong and brave, for you will be a successful leader of my people, and they shall conquer all the land I promised to their ancestors. You need only to be strong and courageous and to obey the letter of every law I gave you through Moses. For if you are careful to obey every one of them, you will be successful in everything you do. You must banish fear and doubt. For remember, the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Joshua assumed his appointed position as leader of God's people. He sent two spies from his camp to investigate the enemy forces on the west bank of the Jordan River, especially at Jericho. The spies arrived at an inn operated by a woman named Rahab. Rahab gave the Israelites refuge from local authorities when they were suspected as being spies. Her actions were prompted out of fear of the God of Israel. She knew that their God was going to give her country to them. In return for her help, the spies promised that Rahab's family would be spared in the impending battle. She was to gather all her family in her home and hang a rope out the window as a sign of their agreement. 3 days later, the spies crossed over the Jordan River and returned to the Israeli camp. They reported to Joshua, "The Lord will certainly give us the entire land, for all the people over there are frightened to death of us." Joshua prepared his people to cross the Jordan River. They were given instructions to follow the priest carrying the Ark of God. Joshua told his people that God was going to do a miracle. When it came time for the Israelites to cross over the Jordan River, the priest went to the water's edge with the Ark of God. God dried up the waters, and the people crossed over on dry ground. This was certainly a tremendous day for Joshua. Joshua and the nation of Israel were ready to follow God's commands and conquer the city of Jericho.
Four more days till the walls fall down. Four more days till the walls.
Joshua was a faithful leader of Israel. He was obedient to all of God's law. He challenged Israel to revere Jehovah and serve him in sincerity and in truth, to worship and obey the Lord alone. Israel remained faithful to Jehovah for only one generation after Joshua's death. Then Israel began to disobey God's law and had a series of relapses into idolatry, followed by the invasions of the promised land by oppressive enemies. Whenever Israel would seriously repent of her sins, God would always raise up a deliverer for his chosen people. Throughout the centuries, God reconciled Israel to himself. Israel's ultimate deliverer is to be found one starlit night, lying in a manger. It came to pass in those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. Everyone went to his own city to be taxed. Thus, Joseph with Mary, his espoused wife, went up out of Galilee from Nazareth into Judea to the tiny village of Bethlehem because he was in the lineage of David. While Mary and Joseph were in Bethlehem, Mary brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger because there was no room in the inn. In the nearby fields, the shepherds kept watch over their flocks.
Glory, glory, glory.
The angel of the Lord appeared and said, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which shall be for all people. For today, in the city of David, there has been born for you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." Hastily, the shepherds came to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the babe, the world's Redeemer, in a manger filled with hay, just as the angel had said. God's word of love had truly come to earth. Our Lord, Emmanuel.
Thank you.
News of this new child, this Savior who had come with men to dwell, spread throughout the countryside. Wise men from the east followed a blazing star that had led them to this child. And they arrived with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Majesty, worship His majesty, unto Jesus.
Then came the soldiers from Herod the Great, who through cunning sought to reach the child. The soldiers looked for him, but he was not there. Mary and Joseph had been warned by the angels, and they had fled into the night out of the land of Judea to dwell with strangers. Yet the soldiers followed Herod's order to slaughter all infant boys under the age of 2 in Bethlehem in an attempt to thwart the predicted Messiah. After a period of time, Mary and Joseph moved the family from Egypt to Nazareth, where Joseph set up a carpenter shop. The baby grew to boyhood, and the boy became a man. God's word tells us, the people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Jesus began to preach and to say, Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. One day, when Jesus was walking by the sea, he saw two brothers, Peter and Andrew, casting their net into the sea. Jesus said to them, Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. They left their nets and followed him. Jesus then saw two other brothers, James and John, who were with their father mending their nets. Jesus called to them and asked them to follow him. Jesus went all about Galilee, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel and healing all manner of disease among the people. Jesus' fame spread rapidly. He had come to bring light to people, ordinary people, just like me and you. For nearly 3 years, Jesus ministered to people. As his followers grew in numbers, he became an imaginary threat to the religious leaders of the day. His teachings of a new relationship to the kingdom of God branded him as a blasphemer and a rebel. Yet the multitudes wanted him to become the kingly Messiah that they had longed for. One day, as Jesus approached Jerusalem, the crowds began to lift him up in praise.
Is your name.
But the praise of the people soon faded. By Thursday of the following week, Jesus had assembled his disciples together to celebrate the Passover meal. Jesus knew that this evening would be his last night on earth before returning to his Father. Now he took unleavened bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body." Next he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Drink from it, all of you, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is to be shed on behalf of many for the forgiveness of sins."
Just for you.
Following that meal, Jesus and his disciples went to the Garden of Gethsemane. Moving away from the three who quickly fell asleep, he knelt to pray as he watched for the torches to appear out of the darkness. In deepest agony, he prayed, "Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Yet not as I will, but as thou wilt." There came a gift of calm, and then a surge of strength and power as he uttered, "My Father, if this cannot pass away unless I drink it, thy will be done." How quickly the soldiers came. They arrested him. They conducted an illegal trial. And they took him before Pilate, the governor, who could find no fault in him. Yet, Pilate sentenced him to die. To this end, Jesus Christ was born, and for this purpose he came into the world. He came to bear witness to truth and to call everyone to repentance and reconciliation with God. He came to give his life as a complete sacrifice, to share the good news to a people who walk in darkness, to help the blind to see, and to liberate all from the powers of this world. He came to give us life so superior to anything that was known that he called it abundant life. He came to gain admittance to the citadel within each of us. He came to establish a kingdom by ruling the hearts of men, women, and children. That afternoon, while he was on the cross, the whole earth was covered with darkness for 3 hours. About 3 o'clock, Jesus shouted, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" A short while later, Jesus shouted out again. He dismissed his spirit, and he died upon the cross. Christ, who being in the form of God, made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Be given to you. Thank you for coming into our world and building a bridge between heaven and our earth, for entering our lives with your transforming influence so that we have the power to love God and to love one another. And to you, O Lord, we give all honor and glory and majesty forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah, 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 for the on behalf of the congregation of First Baptist Church, we hope that you have a very Merry Christmas and that you enjoy this time of year, and we hope that you'll attend our services. Next Sunday night, we'll have a special candlelight and carol service, and we'd invite you to attend that. Merry Christmas and God bless you. Mm-hmm.